ओके, सो आई एम हियर इन द यूजर डेटा मैनेजर एंड आई एम क्रिएटिंग द लोड यूजर व्यू मेथड एंड अगेन सेम थिंग स्ट्रिंग बिल्डर. स्ट्रिंग बिल्डर इक्वल्स टू न्यू स्ट्रिंग बिल्डर SELECT सिलेक्ट स्टार फ्रॉम के. I'll check the name of the table, that is students, STUDENTS, that is STUDENTS, students. Control and S. Now return ABC dot very template. Dot query for list. As we need list, so I'll be writing JDBC query dot list. Okay, so I'll write this and string builder dot to string. Okay, so I'm saving this and I have returned it. And we are having an error over here. I'll just check once if it is working. Camera is working. Yes, it is working. So we are having an error over here, that is add import java.util and again add import map. Okay, so now everything is done and we are retrieving select star from students, that is we'll get the whole list of that particular thing. Okay, so now we'll go in user service. Okay, why this is showing a error? Okay, so change return type, because we have return type over integer, I'll just change it to list map. Okay, now it's done. Control S. Now in user controller we'll get the list, as user list. Okay, so just we'll see if we are getting the list. We'll go to the it will return us which view, that is view user. So we'll go to view user view. So view user, and I'll just print the list over here if I can, and dollar, and what was the name? User list. Okay, control S. So now let's see if it is working or not. I'll just reload. I'll just click view user, and yes, we are in this. You can see load view user is the method name, and now we are having student ID 1, student name, student enrollment number, student ID 2, and so on. We are having the list. So now we can arrange the list in the form of table by writing the whole table. We can make the whole table, that is we can write table table close table. And t head close t head, and I'll write tr close tr and th close th. Name th close th and enrollment number, writing in short form, that is enrollment number. Okay, and what I will do for this is we will have to run a loop, right? Because we are having so many data, three data, so we'll run a loop. But before that, we'll create t body close t body. body, then we'll write. I'll have to again include the JSTL tag. So I'll go to form page. I'll copy this tag. Okay. So I'll save it. I have included the tag. You can see over here. Right. So now this is T body. In T body, I'll write C for each loop. I hope you all are knowing for each loop. Okay. C for each items. Items then dollar. Then dollar. What is the name that I have written? That is user list. User list. Then I have to create a variable that is C. And now I'll end C for each. I'll end this. And insert that. Again, TR. Close TR. ED. Close TD. Okay. So over here, I'll write dollar, dollar C dot name. Now we'll have to check what is the particular value, that is name. Okay, it is name only. Okay C dot name, right? Again same, but C dot, I'll check it over here and we'll select as it is. Control C and control V. Okay, control S. Okay, so we have created a proper view. So now I'll just refresh it. Okay, so you can see that current enrollment number is 1500. Okay, see, now you can see is that we are having the data that is Karan and 1500, Ram and 1212, and Ami and 234. So all our data is over here. You can just remove this. This was for testing purpose. So you can write this Control S, Alt Tab, and I'll do F5. Okay, so all the data are retrieved over here. Okay, so now you can go back and you can do the same thing for edit also and delete also. Just again explain the flow, that is, first you will go to the user controller. Inside user controller, you will go to user service by mentioning the view name, whatever view you want to keep. Whatever view you want to keep, and then we'll go to user service, yes. And inside user service, you will just create the application context in order to match the XML file. And then you will go to user data manager where we'll create the query. So queries are being created over here and it will be submitted to the query. But I highly recommend that you can remove this system.out.print because we should not log it on our screen. We should always have a different logger system for it. That will come to aspect oriented programming and we'll delete this. So now we'll come to aspect oriented programming. That is okay. We are here at aspect oriented programming. I'll just have its program file Spring AOP. Yes, Spring AOP, and I'll have it run. Okay, so it is working. The program is working. I'll show you the program also. It's not a big program. Close all. Okay. Bean XML. Okay. So now we'll first of all, I'd like to give you the basic idea about what is Spring AOP, right? So AOP is a feature in Spring. AOP is basically a feature in Spring, which gives you many things, many support like security, profiling, logging, transaction management, that are security, profiling, logging, transaction management. This all is known as cross-cutting concerns. Cross-cutting concern is just a definition, it's just a term, but these things which provide, which we want to provide our product, that is security, profiling, logging, transaction management. Logging is something that we want to check our error, like every time we were doing system.out.print into that Spring MVC project. So logging is basically the same. That we are logging that where we are getting the error. Security is you code some security stuff and you put it into another thing. So that is security. These are known as cross-cutting concerns because there are layers like UI layer, business logic layer, data access layer. So in between this all layers and in between two products also we need this security, profiling and logging. Between this layer also I'll need logging, between these two layer also I need logging. So that is why it is known as cross-cutting concerns. Okay, so we'll come to next slide. Why we need Spring AOP? Spring AOP is need for cross-cutting concerns. I again told you that security, profiling, logging, these are cross-cutting concerns. So we need to use Spring AOP for that. And now we are on, we can reuse this. Okay, I have created a module called logging. So it's not necessary that I'll only use for my one application. I can use it for all my applications. So we are reusing the thing. I can develop a security code and I can reuse it again in the another application also. Quick development. Quick development is we can quickly develop things if I have already created logging, right? So I can develop my business logic layer very fast. I don't have to worry anything about logging. Focus on one aspect. So let's see if someone wants to focus on security only. So he can go to security aspect oriented programming and he can code everything related to security. And the other person can do profiling, the other person can do logging. So it gives you specialization, right? And enable slash disable. So enable disable is a very important feature that Spring AOP provide, that you can enable this logging, you can disable this logging also. Right. If you want logging, then you can enable. If you don't want logging, you can disable. So this is a very important feature that it provides. Now, I'll give you an example. So let's see, there is object A, object B, object C. We have functions and we have other functions. In between two functions, I want a log message that I am over here. Like how did I did in the Spring MVC? I printed system.out.print to check if it is printing on the console or not. So every time we cannot print it on the console, right? We need to keep it confidential. We need to print this data into another file that will be only accessible by the company. It should not be accessible by any other person. So I'll keep log message, log message, log message. But how many times I'll write log message, it is so cumbersome. If it is a small project, we can write it. But if it is a big enterprise project, then we cannot write log message every time. Okay, so what is the solution for this? So solution for this is you can create a logger object and inside that you can create function and log message, right? And now object A, object B, object C, you will not have to create it, but still you will have to call this function and you will have to write the you'll have to call the function over here for the logger. Over here also you have to call logger. Over here also you have to call logger. Still we are writing the function, right? We are not removing the dependency also. This object A is dependent on this logger. This object B is also dependent on this logger. So we are not removing dependency also, and we are using again the message over here in order to we are using the function over here. Over here. We'll definitely have to create an object of logger and we'll have to write it over here. So again, it is the same thing only that you write log message, or you create another logger function and you use it over here. You will have to write code in order to call also. So that is also same thing only. So what is the proper solution? So the proper solution is aspect oriented programming. We can create logging aspect, transaction aspect. So logging aspect is, for now you can consider it as a special class only. So just consider it as a special class and you will just tell Spring that I want this logging aspect in between these two function, in between these two function, but I don't want logging aspect in this function. I want transaction aspect in these two function. You can tell the spring, but how you will tell the spring? You can tell the spring in by aspect configuration, right? You will have to configure the aspect configuration. In this aspect configuration, you will have to tell the spring that I want logger function over here, I want transaction function over here, and I want logging function over here. So spring will do it on its own only. And this object A, object B, object C will not come to know that they are accessing the logging aspect method. You will get to know when we'll come to the program. So, and this is, and whenever we'll run the program, the aspect configuration is all is maintained. And when the program will run, it will come to know that, oh, over here I have to call the logging method. So it will go to the aspect logging aspect, and it will call the method, and it will do the function between over here. Everything is mentioned in this. You can also consider this as triggers, right? In triggers, in database we use triggers. So sometimes we are using that after insert, I will follow this trigger that your data is inserted. It should be displayed. So it is a form of trigger. In after delete also, there are triggers that delete this data from other tables also. So trigger is something which acts on its own only after certain thing. So we provide a function after this, that particular logging aspect will run on its own only. It will not have to call. So that all the method that we want to call and we want to configure, we are writing in the aspect configuration, right? So now, why Spring AOP? So these are the uses of Spring AOP. Spring AOP enables aspect-oriented programming in Spring applications. Aspect-oriented programming. Spring AOP provides aspect-oriented programming. That is, we can create this aspect configuration. Spring AOP provides that. Then is aspects enable modularization of concern. Modularization of concerns is, this is different module, this is different module, this object C is different module. You can create another transaction management module. If you want another transaction management module, you can create it. So there are different modules, and you can help them test different modules. You can reuse the different modules. And whenever there is a problem, you can always check a particular module. You don't have to check the whole function, right? You don't have to perform the checking on the whole project. So you can check a particular module. Then is add cross-cutting concerns before, after, and around the logic. As I mentioned, cross-cutting concerns is nothing. Cross-cutting concerns are your functions, or they can be try-catch block also. But and you can write the logging aspect over here. But how will the function come to know that I have to perform logging aspect before this particular function, like before this function or after this function? So Spring aspect provide us before, after, and around the logic. Spring AOP provides us with before, after, and around methods so that we can particularly write, we can particularly execute the function before this function or after this function. We'll come to this in detail afterwards. Then it's easy to maintain the code in present and future. So as it provides modularization, it will be very easy to modify this particular object, this particular aspect. We can also modularize this particular aspect. We can also modularize any particular aspect if it is created. So it's very easy for us to do. Okay, these are the advices that Spring provides. That is advice. What is advice? That is represent an action taken by an aspect at a particular join point. What is join point? Okay, so join point. Join point is a point in the program such as execution, exception handling, and etc. So advice, I told you that they are before advice, after advice. So after advice is the function will trigger after this function, that is after. And if I use before, so it will be over here before. So it will execute before only when this function runs. So that is advice. And what is join point? This function on which we are executing the before and the after method is called as the join point. So this is the particularly the join point on which before function and after function will be executed. That is after and before. And it's point cut. What is point cut? Point cut is an expression language of AOP that matches join points. Point cut. So when we are writing this logging aspect, we can also write it into our method that we are using this expression. Point cut point cut is basically an expression language of AOP that matches. So this point cut, we used to mention it in this file, that is aspect configuration. We mention it in it. So I'll give you the example of point cut in the next slide. So this is a point cut, @ point cut, and that is execution. And my method, what is this star? This star is for all. Wait a second. Oh, Papa. I have this point cut over here, and I'm writing the expression, this particular expression, that execution of this has to be done before my method. That is my method. My method can be anything. You can write any function, any method, or anything. That is execute this point cut before this particular method. Okay. And join points are there. You can use before, after, after returning, after throwing, and around. Before is before that particular function runs. After is after that particular function runs. After returning is after that return. After returning, that after the function is returned, you can run that. And after throwing is by chance an exception is thrown. So you can run that particular method after throwing an exception. If an exception is thrown, you can write that particular method after that. And around is special case. Around is before also and after also. So that is combination of before and after. Okay, these are the things that I explained only before only. That is before advice. That is it executes before the join point. After advice, that is advice to execute after a join point. After returning advice, that is advice to execute after the join point completes. That is after the particular join point is completed, then only this after return advice will work. Then is around advice. Advice that surrounds a join point like method invocation. That is it surrounds the method, that is before also and after also. Okay, now I'll just show you the implementation of the method of the Spring AOP. So this is my Spring AOP. I have created a file, and don't worry, I have a proper video on it that I had created when I was presenting my ALA to Ami ma'am when I was in college. So I have provided the link over here. You can go and access it there. The whole project, the whole program is typed and shown over there. You can go there and do. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to explain you the whole program. Okay. So I'll just minimize it. Okay. Now first is Spring AOP. So this is my main page. This is my main function, that is public static void main string args, and in that application context, that is context, and new class application context bean.xml. bean.xml, as we have done in Spring, we are just getting the file, that is bean.xml. This is my bean.xml. Okay, this is my whole bean.xml file. So we are just getting the file over here. We are just getting the path of the file over here, right? So now we are creating a method called student. We are not creating method. We are instantiating student. Student is already created. That is, you can see in projects, how is the method? See, student is a file. And this is my student file. In that, I have created the getter and setter method. That is private integer age and string name. So I'll be getting the age of the person and name of the person, right? And I have also printed this print throw exception method where it will print the exception. Okay. And when I'll try to get the name, it will print the name and the name which it will get from the function, that is the main function over here. Right. So I have just instantiated. So it will go to that particular bean, get bean, and student is the ID. So now we'll go to the bean file. Okay. We are in the bean file. I'll just reduce the size so that you can see properly. Options. Cancel. Okay, so here we'll come we'll come to this part, but first we'll come over here. I've created a bean. This is a bean where I have given the id student. As you can see, get bean and the id student. Okay, so now class is spring aop dot student. So this is the class name, as we were doing in spring mvc also, that is spring aop. This is the spring aop, this is the spring aop package name, and student is the file name, right? This is the file name. Okay, so after that I had created id bean logging in the class spring aop, and that is logging. This is logging, right? So we'll go to logging. This is logging. This logging id we are going to use it over here while this spring aop configuration. So don't worry about that. So this is spring aop dot logging. So we are going into this class logging. In this logging I have created methods that are before advice, after advice, after returning advice, and after throwing advice. Okay, so it after before advice it will go, it will print going to set up student profile. After returning advice it will print student profiling has been set up. Okay, so now we'll go to our bean file, and it was this bean is created and it will reflect to this beginning, that is reference logging. Reference is logging, right? This is the reference, and I have given the id log. Okay, and now this is the point cut. Point cut is basically where do you want to insert that particular method, right? So what expression I have given is execution star dot spring aop star. So for every method, I've also written select all. This is the id, but what I have done is star spring aop star for each and every method in this spring aop. Each and every method, that is whenever I call this, it will write a before, it will write after. So you can see over here that for all, in this before also, before advice, this is aop, before, that is point reference. Point reference, what is point reference? Point reference is for what particular function you want to execute. So I have written select all. Why I have written select all? Because I wanted to print when I get name or when I get age. So before get name it will print before advice, after get name is executed it will print after advice. Okay, so it will print after advice. Then is after returning. After returning is what? When I'm completed with whole, this whole particular function I'm completed, after returning, after I return with that particular function, the after returning method will execute it. After return method will execute it. Now this is the method name. Before advice it will match in the logging method, that is before advice. This method is matched, the spelling should be same, that is before advice. Before advice, after advice, the spelling should be same, after advice. And after returning advice, the spelling should be same, after returning advice. So it will print in the same way. So now the whole program will run and the output will be like this. I just pin the output. Okay, so first it will go in the spring, it will application context, it will get the path, it will get everything, then it will get the student data from the get bean, because we have given the student id over there, that I'll show you in the bean. See over here, I have given the id student, that is name, that is name, that is Karan, and age, that is 21. Okay, so that bean will be given over here, though it will access the bean over here because I have set it up over here, that is student.student.getbean. So it will be in student, this data will be in student. Now student.getName. So when you can see over here, I have not written anything that I want to print. See, before name it is printing, going to set up student profile. I have not written over here that I am printing anything. So this is separating my business logic and the logging profile. Okay, so I can focus more on my business logic, and this is not dependent. Everything I have configured over here. So this will be configured because I have written select all. and before advice. So when this particular method is getting called get name, so I'll control and get click. So that is get name, name. But before that, going to setup student profile will be printed, because select all, I have done it for select all the methods. And before advice, what is before advice? We'll go into logging. Before advice is going to setup student profile. So it is printing, going to setup student profile. Then it will print the name, because I have called over here the method get name. So name and name. Now student profile has been set up. Why this is being called? Because in the bean, I have also mentioned select all AOP after point cut, after point cut reference. So that is after this method, after this get name method, this particular advice will be run. So that is after advice. I'll check after advice in the logging method, that is logging. So after advice, that is student profile has been set up. Okay. So student profile has been set up. So now returning, this whole function is over. So returning, I also mentioned returning over here, that is point cut, returning, select all, that is after returning, So we'll check after returning in the logging. So here after returning, so that is returning, and the return dot values dot to string. This to string is done so that we can get the object value into in string type. So it is printing current, right? So the same thing when I call age, that is I'll go in the student, spring AOP main class, that is student dot get age. So student dot get age, I'm getting the age. But before that, going to setup profile is being executed before I have given before advice, and student profile has been set up before I have given after advice, and returning 21 is printed before we have given one more after throwback advice. Okay, so this is basically the Spring AOP whole concept. So Spring AOP concept is something which provides you with logging, transaction management, and everything. But you want to separate it from your main logic, right? You'll separate it from your main logic so that you can focus on the main part, that is the business part. So you can have it more efficiently. And whenever you want to switch it off, you can just come over here and you can remove this particular line. So it will not be working. So it will not work. So this is the part of AOP. So you can also check my video which I have made on AOP. The whole coding is done in this link. This is the link. You can go to it. So these are the sources which I have been using. That is Edureka and JavaBrains. JavaBrains is a very good website. You can visit javabrains.io. They also have a YouTube channel, javabrains.io. Okay. So we are done with the presentation. So this is the Spring AOP and Spring MVC.
Wow, Karan, I should clap for you.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Very nicely you explained Spring MVC, JDBC template, insert, list view, and also the aspect-oriented programming. I thought after four, you would yourself say that, ma'am, I want to finish now. But it is really good about you that you could take to 5:15 instead of 4 to 5:15, and people are listening also. That is also good. Otherwise, people think, "Yaar, kya hai webinar hai? Let us finish that." But no, that is really good.
No, ma'am, this Spring MVC is basically very important for job purpose also. Yes. Without Spring MVC, you'll not get a job. Definitely, you'll not get a job. Yeah.
That is why I told you to come and deliver the talk, because you yourself are working with that.
Yes. And the error which came in between the Spring MVC was I did not include the jar file.
That is okay.
I had to include the jar file.
That is okay. That happens.
In companies, we don't consider JIL file because we are already using their methods only. Everything is included. So I just skipped the jar file. So afterwards, I came to know, okay, this I have to include this jar file. That's
right. Okay, but see, it is really tough to show the things working online only. That is everything you are writing online and you are running the things. It is tough for many, many, many good people also, because people are making error and they are not able to solve. So it is really good for you. Hats off to you. And one more thing is, two deaths were there in your own family, still you are ready to give the webinar. That is really good. Hats off to you, man. Yeah. Hats off to you. Great. Thank you.
And thank you everyone for listening. I hope you get the tutorial. I think the recording will be posted by Ami ma'am, so you can refer also. And I'll be also sharing the project which we made right now. That is this particular this Spring page. I'll be sharing it with ma'am. So ma'am will share the project with you. You can run it on your laptops also. And trust me, this whole project is this whole method that I used to develop the Spring MVC is used in NJ India Invest. Yeah, there are some other things also which I have not included due to some company restriction, but the whole process is same. So if you learn this particular thing and you apply to NJ India Invest, I think you will get a job over there. And for internship also, I'll promote my company, because first I was given training in NJ India Invest. 1 month I was into training part, and it was fantastic. I have many of my friends in bigger tech companies. NJ India is also a bigger company only. It is number one in mutual funds, but it is not number one in technology, because it is doing its own work only. But I have my friends in big companies. I don't want to name that companies. So they are not giving proper training over there. They are just telling that you can do it on your own. But yeah, here in NJ India, they will give you proper training. And I have Sohil sir over there, Mr. Sohil Sheikh. His training is very good. So you can, of course, apply for internship over there. You can, of course, apply for training. And you can also apply for jobs.
Yeah, that's really good.
And NJ India is not a small company. It's a very big company. You should visit NJ India Invest once. So you can come to know.
Yeah, always it is good to work with small companies so that you can learn so many things. In big companies, many a times it happens that you are getting only maintenance project. But in small company, you have to do each and everything yourself. And that way we can learn too much.
Many of the time they also tell you to do the testing part also. They send you for testing. So if you want to be a developer, you are forced to become a tester. So that is why I just wanted to say that NJ India is best company in Surat also, and in all over India also. It has its name. It is number one in mutual fund, so it's a very big company. It only handles its own projects. Like you can understand that to handle their own projects only, they have set up a IT department. So it's a very huge company, and it will take care of you also. Okay, so ma'am, we can end the session over here.
Sure. Anyone want to ask anything to Karan? Okay. Students, do you want to ask anything, or you want to try yourself and then after you will ask him something? I think they want to try and then after they will ask you, isn't
it? Okay, sure. I'll just mail the project to you, ma'am, and you can share it with the students.
Sure. Okay.
Yeah. And the jar file, don't forget to include the jar file.
Sure.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Karan. Have a good day. Bye.
Same to you, ma'am.
Okay.